let's talk about the main tips on using Twinmotion, which, regardless of your level, I'm sure will be very handy in your everyday use. If you have any questions, just drop them below as always, and let's dive into the list. Use a suitable PC. Like all real-time rendering software, Twinmotion needs a next-generation PC to function at its best. The components to consider are the RAM, for which I recommend at least 32 GB, and the graphics card, which I recommend either NVIDIA RTX or AMD RX 6000 series or higher, in both cases with at least 15,000 benchmark points, which is a score given to graphic cards based on their performance. The higher the benchmark, the better the graphic card. Although Windows remains the best choice for rendering, on Twinmotion you can render high-level projects even on Mac operating system. Efficient 3D model. Without getting around it, if a 3D project is modeled carefully, rendering will be a breeze, especially with Twinmotion. If you have correctly assigned materials to surfaces in your 3D modeling software, in Twinmotion, in a matter of seconds, you will replace them with materials from the huge Twinmotion OmegaScan library, and you will be ready to render the project right away. Finally, pay attention to the direction of the surfaces, so as not to burden the file. Twinmotion shows only the positive directions of the surfaces. The negative direction is made transparent. Although you can force the program to consider the negative surfaces as well, I recommend that you change the structure of the solid directly on the 3D modeling program to prevent Twinmotion from weighing the file down. Do not touch the imported project. To avoid losing the connection between the 3D modeling software and Twinmotion, I recommend that you do not modify the 3D project directly into Twinmotion in any way. Whatever changes you need to make, whether it is moving an object, deleting a component, or changing material to a single surface, do it on your 3D modeling program and update the file in Twinmotion accordingly. If you use Geometry Import, moving or deleting or rotating a 3D model in Twinmotion, at the next project update, the moved or deleted or rotated object will return to its original position. On the contrary, if you use the direct link, the modification will remain unchanged in Twinmotion following model update, but you will have lost the connection between 3D and render. The modified object will have two different positions on Twinmotion and on your 3D modeling software. This is the most objective advice on the list, but personally, I always prefer that my design on 3D and on Twinmotion are always perfectly connected to each other. Less is more. Once you have imported the 3D into Twinmotion, don't waste time characterizing every single corner of the space. Set up the views that you plan to export right away and characterize only the space that will be rendered. However, pay attention to the reflections. If in an interior scene you are looking frontally at a mirror or a particular reflective surface, it is very important that behind the camera the space is properly characterized. Otherwise, in the reflection, you will simply see a white surface. Obviously, the same argument applies to outdoor renderings. Looking at windows, it makes sense to strategically place trees or other elements at the reflection. Details are very important. Rendering a scene characterized with low-poly or high-poly 3D models make all the difference in the world when it comes to final quality and pursuit of realism. That's why I recommend using only high-level 3D models, such as those found in the Twinmotion and Megascan libraries. Of course, though, there will always be objects missing from the list. That's why it's important to know that as of today, there are a lot of online websites from which you can download and import all kinds of 3D models of the highest level into Twinmotion. In this regard, know that I have a completely free library consisting of hundreds of 3D models in Twinmotion format ready to be used. If you are interested, click here on this link or go to the description to see the video where I talk about it and explain how to get it. To finish with details, know that in Twinmotion you have the possibility to use hundreds and hundreds of decals, two-dimensional elements that you apply to surface to increase their visual detail. Very useful, especially in exterior views. These, beside adding details, are introducing the next tip. Make it imperfect. Decals, in fact, add imperfections to surfaces, putting them on a realistic plane. House walls are not perfect. Streets are full of stains and cracks, and floors are never perfectly clean. Add to this the 3D models, and in particular, their position. Don't set all the chairs around the table perfectly centered, don't use only closed books, and don't insert carpets without fold. Enrich the design with chairs rotated differently from each other, forgotten books opened on the table, and carpets that survived the fight between two brothers. Imperfections create perfection. Use PBR materials. Use only materials with good textures, and above all, do not look for and use textures downloaded directly from Google Images. Most of the time, the result is a material with a strong and annoying repetition that is not optimizable in any way. Solve this problem by using the thousands of materials made available by Twinmotion and Megascan, knowing that these are all materials that can be modified at any time. Can find a material with waifu effect for the doors of your interiors? Well, create it by using one from the library and modifying its color and saturation. In case that's not enough for you, download texture online only from specialized websites, which provide exclusively seamless textures that they never repeat along the surface to which they are applied. The most important thing, however, is that these websites also share the texture to be used to characterize the main aspects of materials. Roughness and normal are the two textures that should be used for any material. Keep the file light. Know that once you have characterized the project, depending on the elements you have used, the final weight of the file can reach up to several gigabytes. To optimize it, always keep an eye on the stats menu, where you have an overview of the weight of the textures and 3D models in the scene. Identify the excessively heavy elements and replace them with lighter ones. Also, always keep an eye on the materials menu and occasionally click on the button to delete unused materials. Doing so will allow you to move through the scene much more smoothly. Finally, while characterizing the scene, hide all the elements that do not make sense to display, especially vegetation, paths, and artificial lights. You will only reactivate them when creating media, but only those that you see directly. For example, if you don't see vegetation in an interior scene, just turn off the container with all the 3D vegetation models. Optimize light quality. When using the path tracer, there is little to improve beyond samples per pixel, but with Lumen, it is most important to always turn on the Accurate option from the rendering menu. Doing so will greatly increase the quality of the shadows and highlights, and you will have the ability to change the softness of the shadows even at artificial lights. Continuing, natural light can be created by choosing an HDRI sky or by using Twinmotion's native sky. If you choose an HDRI sky from the Twinmotion library, pay close attention to the preview of the image you choose. If your ultimate goal is to create a view where the sun's rays are filtered by clouds, you should not choose an HDRI where the sun has no clouds obscuring it, because otherwise, the end result will see the sun's rays directly hitting the project. For the same reason, if you want to create a bright, warm-colored image, you will have to choose a sky that fits your needs. And the only way to do it is by consulting the HDRI previews directly from the library. Obviously, the same principle applies to using Twinmotion's native sky, with the difference that here you will be the one to create the desired effect, especially by intervening in the 3D clouds menu. In addition to this, I recommend that you keep the auto exposure on, since this option compensates for the brightness of the scene, so that the brightest part of the space is properly exposed. It is a great help to always have properly lit project without ever having to change many parameters. Finally, never forget the highlights and shadows parameters, which allows you to intervene exclusively either on the lighting, thus preventing a scene from burning, or on the shadows, to preventing the scene from being too dark. Don't forget about effects. Often forgotten, the FX are the last option at our disposal before the final export that can really make a difference. Of course, it does not replace a post-production done in programs like Photoshop, but it gives us a big hand to make a scene more or less contrasted or saturated, depending of course on the FX we want to render. And finally, here are some bonus tips. Always keep Twinmotion updated to the latest version of Able. The latest version is always the best performing and has many advantages over previous versions, both in terms of performance and usable commands. Always keeps your PC's graphics card drivers up to date. Once every 1 or 2 months, check for available updates and install them as soon as possible to speed up the use of Twinmotion. Join the Facebook official community group that has over 120,000 people. Here you find answers to any of your doubts and you can learn a lot from experienced users. Never stop learning. My YouTube channel is a source of inspiration, but there are many others. Probably the best channel to follow are the official Twinmotion channel and GemsView, which in particular share the top-notch video tutorials. Finally, sign up for the waiting list for my training portal on Twinmotion. It will be available very, very soon. Thank you very much for watching this video to the very end and for being part of my community. I strongly ask you to leave a comment with the topic you would like me to cover in the next video, as you have always been my source of inspiration. That said, I wish you a good day or evening and see you very, very soon. Ciao!